Words and emotions.
Oh, that's a good one. We should all practice self-control on a daily basis, but especially here at CMS with all of our new safety protocols.
True that. We can all do our part to show self-control with our masks, social distancing, and following the safety expectations to help keep the spread of COVID-19 low.
Hey Cougars, now is time to order your yearbook, and it's super easy to order. But you can only order online right now. They are only $25 for our back-to-school special.
2020-2021 yearbooks can be ordered at www.jostens.com or from the homepage of our CMS website. This is sure to be a year to remember, so make sure you are ordering yours now.
Attention all 7th and 8th grade girls. There will be a basketball information meeting on October 13th and 15th at 7:15 a.m.
This meeting will be held in the cafeteria. If you want to hear how to become a Lady Cougar, please attend. They'll talk about possible open gyms and everything you need for tryouts. Playing basketball for Congress is a blast.
We hope to see you there. If you have any questions, please see Coach C in room 110.
Our fantastic football team will take on Park Hill South today, October 6th.
Good luck to all of our amazing players. Go get that win. Are you ready for this week's Hispanic Heritage Challenge question? If you would like to participate, get out your laptops now and fill out the tiny URL form at www.tinyurl.com/Hispanic Heritage Challenge.
Again, to participate, get out your laptops now and go to this site, www.tinyurl.com/Hispanic Heritage Challenge. This week's Hispanic Heritage Challenge is, she is a Mexican artist known for her self-portraits.
Her work often depicted her personal pain and passion. For example, as a child, she suffered from polio and almost died in a car accident.
As a result of the car accident, she underwent over 30 surgeries.
She is often shown with a unibrow.
Again, next week's trivia is, she is a Mexican artist known for her self-portraits.
Her work often depicted her personal pain and passion. For example, as a child, she suffered from polio and almost died in a car accident.
As a result of the car accident, she underwent over 30 surgeries.
She is often shown with a unibrow.
If you know who this famous Hispanic person is, make sure you're submitting your answer to www.tinyurl.com/Hispanic Heritage Challenge.
Good luck.
Are you ready for our weekly Wicker Challenge?
The past few weeks we have focused on writing, inquiry, cooperation, and organization. Hopefully you will occasionally look back at your courageous reminder, your person of courage, and your cooperative puzzle piece to remember that you have #CureYourCourage.
And we hope your binder is nice and organized. This week we are going to focus on the R, reading.
Our Wicker Challenge for you this week is to find at least 20 minutes a day to read for enjoyment.
Reading is a great way to exercise the brain and use your imagination.
It also can give you a nice escape from some of the things that may be stressing you out.
Let's find those 20 minutes, Cougars, to expand our minds, our imaginations, and find our peace. Hey, do you know what COVID-19 and dogs have in common?
No, I don't, but I sure would love to know.
Well, you're in luck. Here's another special report from our virtual reporter, Isaiah Iono.
Good morning, Congress students. Recently, there has been a new breakthrough in COVID-19 and how to diagnose it, and it might be in a new way you wouldn't expect it. It's to your average house dog. Yep, you heard me right. They're training dogs to sniff out COVID-19. These dogs are trained by cans and wheels. They'll put COVID in one can and spin the wheel. The dog will then follow the wheel until it stops and he finds the can with COVID. If the dog finds the right can, he can get a reward. This is repeated over and over until he can sniff COVID off of a human. This is the same type of training they use for drug dogs. Blaze is one of 9 dogs enrolled in this project. They are training to see if a dog can tell the difference between the smells and a person infected with the COVID-19. As COVID continues to spread, we should start to take stuff more seriously and have a good day, students.
Wow, who knew?
I know, right? Thank you very much, Isaiah, for that interesting news story. We have a new segment for you today called 31 Days of Halloween. This show will be airing every day for the rest of the month of October.
In this segment, three people from a group of selected tutorials will be competing to answer Halloween-related questions as fast as they can.
Whoever gets the most questions correct wins a special prize at the end of the video.
Why don't we take a look at their very first show?
Welcome to our new show on CGTV. This show is called 31 Days of Halloween. All throughout the month, we will be asking a lot of different types of questions.
Today, we will be focused on the candy portion of Halloween, also known as the best part. So our three contestants today are
Olivia,
Mario,
Bella.
So are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay then, our first question is, what is the most common candy given out on Halloween night? You haven't given me the choice yet, calm down.
Oh!
Okay. Your choices, three choices are Kit Kat bars, M&M's, Skittles, or Starburst. Those are four. It's fine.
Ooh, that's hard.
Okay, Olivia?
Kit Kats.
That is wrong.
Okay.
Oh, I'm gonna say M&M's.
That is also wrong.
Dang!
Starburst.
That is also wrong.
It was Skittles!
It was Skittles! Which I think is really weird because I don't love Skittles.
I don't either.
But since none of you got a point, then that means that you're all tied at zero, which means that we can basically start fresh. Okay, so the answer was C, Skittles. 1 point goes to nobody. But it's fine. You guys got another question. Honey?
Our next question is what is known as the best candy in America?
Your four options are Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, Snickers, Sour Patch Kids, or Twix. Olivia?
Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
That is right.
Oh, I was gonna say that.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cups were supposedly the best ranked.
The answer is A, Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. The point goes to Olivia.
Okay, and our final question is, what are the three main colors from biggest to smallest part of candy corn?
Your choices are A, black, white, and orange, B, yellow, orange, and white, C, orange, yellow, white, or D, all candy corns are made different.
Olivia?
I'm gonna say D.
That is incorrect.
Oh, yeah.
B. That is correct.
It
was B, which is yellow, orange, and white. So, tiebreaker. So, you guys can go ahead and answer what is my favorite chocolate Halloween treat? Olivia? Right. Okay. So, that means that Olivia was our winner. You won a coupon to Macy's Pizza.
Ooh, yay.
That's all for our show today. Thanks for tuning in.
Bye-bye.
Wow, what a great show.
Remember, they will be choosing new people for the show every day, so be prepared. You never know who will be chosen next.
Well, that's all for today. I'm Hallie, and today is Tuesday, October 6th.
And I'm McKenna, and it's a red day.
See you later, Cougars.